Hey, so in this video I show you how to make a Grützwurst at home. On the meat side, we also need some groats in addition to the meat. You can cook them as described on the packaging. Use some broth or stock for it, and then some pork backfat and pork belly, salt, and marjoram, white pepper, allspice, and cloves. And then some lard or butter and onion, and we need blood. For the blood, you can either use blood powder and then fill it up with water or milk, or if you get fresh pig's blood, that's completely fine, even better actually, but it's really hard to get, so yeah, you can use some blood powder and start the process. First, cut the meat and fat into cubes. And then you can cook the meat in a saucepan for 60 to 70 minutes at approximately 80 degrees Celsius, which is 176 degrees Fahrenheit. And in the meantime, you can chop the onions roughly and add them to a pan with some butter or lard. And let them simmer over low heat and let them cook through. They should not get crispy, but they should be evenly caramelized and get a really nice taste. In the meantime, then grind the spices and the salt into a fine powder. This makes sure that it distributes evenly later on in the mixing process. And then grind everything through the finest perforated disc. So the onions, the lard, and also the meat pieces and the fat pieces. And then you can add the cooked groats and the blood. Also add the spices. And then mix everything well together. And now it's time to fill the mass. You can either cook it into jars or use casings. I'm using the easy method. Just fill it into a oiled up baking dish and preheat the oven to 180 degrees Celsius, which is about 356 degrees Fahrenheit, and bake it in there for 30 to 40 minutes. And then you could either eat it warm, or you could also let it cool down, slice it up and fry it again. As you can see, nice consistency, looks beautiful. And here you can see it on the right side. I have a cooled down version on a bread with butter. And on the left side, I refried it in a pan with some oil. Let's give it a taste test. And yeah, it's a traditional sausage. But however, the marjoram, the spices, they give it a really nice taste. Also, you could taste the blood, but it's not that prominent. It has a nice consistency, as you can see. Yeah, I can totally recommend. Try it at home. It's easy. You don't need a sausage stuffer or anything because you can bake it in a baking dish. Try it out. And yeah, as always, the full recipe below. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel and give me a thumbs up. And I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.